Today we're going to talk about Breinigsville, one of the fastest growing areas in the state of Pennsylvania. The fastest growing area in the state of Pennsylvania. Unfortunately, I do not remember where I got that fact, but when I was doing the research for Breinigsville, that came up and I wrote it down. So stay tuned for more. My name is Tiffany. I'm a local realtor in the greater Allentown area. My office is in Allentown, close to the Walmart by Trexler Town. So I am serving the greater Allentown area. Okay, so if you have real estate needs in this area, please reach out. I am happy to help. When I looked up Breinigsville, it says that it's 11 miles south of Allentown. So I guess I'm not really sure what they use as the central point of Allentown, because I feel like Route 100 is the town, like a county line border. Because if you go to Route 100, some shops are Allentown and on the other side are Breinigsville. And I'm going to insert a clip here so you can kind of see it. I'm using Google Maps on my phone to highlight Yaco's, which is on Route 100. You'll notice the address is Allentown, PA, 18106. Okay, then we'll go across the street to Cross Toyota, which is on the other side of Route 100. And you'll notice that the address is Breinigsville, PA. All right, now we're not done. We're going to go across the street from Krause, which is Gerber, and you'll notice that the address is Fogelsville, PA. So weird. Okay, so Breinigsville is southwest of Allentown. It's kind of right before you get to Kutztown, and it's about 15 miles from the Lehigh Valley Airport, and it's about an hour out of Philly and about 2 hours out of New York City. So depending on what you know about the area, Easton is at the top, meaning that it's closest to New Jersey, okay? Breinigsville would be at the very bottom, meaning it's close, the furthest away from New Jersey. And Allentown is, you know, so Easton is up here, Breinigsville is down here, Allentown is here, and Bethlehem is here. And then all of the other towns, you know, in Allentown are kind of, you know, in the periphery of those towns. But this area is the greater Lehigh Valley area. The airport is ABE, Allentown, Bethlehem, Easton. So some of this information I did get from Wikipedia. And something that's interesting is it said in the 70s and 80s, some warehouses moved into the area because of the location, being close to New York City, close to Philadelphia, on the East Coast, and that the land was inexpensive. There are a lot of warehouses in the area and just in Breinigsville. And like I said, if you cross Route 100, there's even more warehouses on the other side. But just some warehouses that are in Breinigsville, for example, there is a B. Braun warehouse, there's R. Donnelly, there's Wakefern, which is like a ShopRite grocery store, there's FedEx, there's Olympus. I have a couple more. There's Sam Adams and Bimbo Bakeries. And that's just a few. And like I said, if you cross Route 100, you'll see more warehouses on the other side. I know they just built a really big Dr. Pepper Keurig warehouse back there. There's Owens & Minor's. There's Coca-Cola. That's just to name a few that I can see that have visible signs that I could differentiate. So just in that Breinigsville area, there are a lot of warehouses. Oh my goodness, I can't believe I forgot a really big one. There's an Amazon warehouse here in Breinigsville. According to niche.com, 71% of the people in this area are homeowners and the other 29% are renters. And niche.com has about 30 reviews on Breinigsville, so, and they are all over the place. So if you wanted to hear some reviews from people who live in the area, you could definitely check out their website and get some feedback on the community itself. Some other notes about Breinigsville is it's in Upper Macungie Township. It's served by Parkland Schools and the Parkland Library. The Velodrome is in Breinigsville, and it has a big biker community, so you will see a lot of people biking around in the area. It also has two vineyards, which are Clover Hill and Vine Crest. They also have their own park, their own police. They didn't have that before, that's new. And then they also have their own post office. That's just a couple things to, you know, the small town of Breinigsville. Something else about Velodrome, which is where the biking community that I mentioned, is they also host the farmer's market. But the farmer's market has kind of been quiet, or they haven't been hosting it lately because of COVID. So hopefully they'll get back to hosting the farmer's market this spring. Oh, there's also a new community coming up, in over 55 community in Breinigsville, which I believe is the first over 55 community in Breinigsville. Okay, guys, let's go for a drive. We're going to stop first at Breinigsville Park. So I just drove, and then first thing I noticed was the basketball courts. Just took a little picture. There were some guys there, but I didn't want to get them. Then I just drove over to the softball, baseball fields. There's two fields here at the park. There's also a walking trail. I'm not sure how long it is. Some of the people told me they estimate about a mile. I know that there's a baseball team that plays here called B Vets, which I believe is Breinigsville Vets, but I'm pretty sure it allows anybody to play. Then also at the park, you have, you know, the kiddie play area. And then over there, if you look beyond that flagpole, is where the other baseball field is. Then I just drove over to the Breinigsville Post Office, and it was still open for people who need lockbox access. So you can go in and then you could, you know, get access to your lockbox. And then I also noticed one of these bulletin boards, which are cool, the original Craigslist. And then I just drove around town a little bit. This is basically old Breinigsville, not the newer communities, but the original communities. If you meet any people that have lived here for a long time, they'll tell you that all the newer communities used to be farmland. So this is just kind of what it looks like in Breinigsville, where you are not in one of the newer communities. And if you're curious about some of the newer communities, you can check out my videos on Coldwater Crossing or Highgate. And I have lots more videos coming about different communities in Breinigsville and Allentown in general. So I just kind of left the residential area and drove over to Grimm Road, which is where you will find a lot of the warehouses. Right there is the FedEx warehouse in that white building with the diamonds on it. Back there is like a Home Depot warehouse as well. On my right is where the Amazon warehouses are. So there's lots of warehouses, kind of different roads that will lead you to the different warehouses in this area. But this is where I find most of them to be. They kind of feed off of Grimm Road.
Thanks so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next.